world begins and the world ends with the Allah. And then gradually you can say Allah. So let's try to do it. Stay in our back. Breathe in. And then we breathe out. We make the sound that comes from the Allah.
Excuse me, light jala denge aap udhar room mein, please?
So music is sort of an excuse for keeps your spirits high when you can take the time to get out of the house and meet other people and enjoy the music and just be prepared to. And the last part I'm going to talk about music in the life of other religions like Christianity and Judaism. You know about King David, Dawood. He is also mentioned in the Quran. He was actually a very fine man. He was able to play the harp and he was able to compose songs and poetry. So he composed, I think, more than 187 songs that are written in the Bible. And he used to use music as a vehicle to calm his emotions, to ward off the evil effects of his personal and political life, and to reconnect with his creator. And with this same energy, many composers of the classical Western classical tradition, like Bach, Johann Sebastian Bach, Franz Schubert, and even from my country, Michael Gold, Nico Schroeder, he also composed four symphonies on that. Actually, the symphony also has four parts, like the classical raga, a beginning, an alaf, then a slower part with the main theme, then a rhythmic, a festive part, like so belonging and group, festive part also, and finally the culmination.